The system that we're gonna follow is, we allow people to the floor on a staff basis, I'm gonna assume that it's only in staff, I don't know properly or not, but that's a decision, people who are all best in charge, make a decision. But we'll have three people, in addition to the first person's phone, we ask another question, and we'll go back, and we'll remain in line, that's fine, we'll be the next one up. So, three more people, and presumably you're approved by the OS, so go ahead.
To clarify, there's three questions from us, and one from you to the panel, and then...
Well, I thought you got a comment from the question that was made, if you wanna ask a question, that's fine too.
My name is Doug Johnson, I'm a member of the International Brotherhood of Elective Workers of Local 46. For 40 years, we as a country have been very complacent. Very, very complacent. Now we're finally woken up. Change is slow, and the gentleman here mentioned that back in the early 70s, they had a list of demands and they followed through with those demands. But you must understand that this takes time. And as the lady before me said, we are in the embryonic stages of this movement, okay? We need to take this one step at a time. The pyramids were not built in a day. The Constitution was not written overnight. And we also need to remember that the corporate media out there is portraying our movement as nothing but a bunch of homeless youth, a bunch of people with health issues, mental health issues, homeless people, homeless families, fights, all this negative media that we're getting from the corporate media people is a product of 40 years of the social degradation that we have received through the administration, through the politics where we have been placed about. Unions, religious groups, seniors, school students, and the police officers need to be on the same page in order for us to make this movement succeed. But we need to embrace all, and we need to listen to all, to understand everyone's needs. This movement isn't going to change overnight. We're moving one step at a time, and the first step was the divestment. And I have talked to the King County Labor Council to try to divest their funds to the big corporate banks. I have talked to the Washington State Labor Council. I'm getting tepid results through our international union on this. But that's the first step in the process. The next step we got is the super committee and special session of Olympia that starts on the 28th. And we all need to be active on this. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Occupy a couple times. I've not been part of the General Assembly, but I've been
I've sat in on a couple of the process groups. What I want to say is the way that our democracy looks like to me right now is that it's very, and I think best intentions, Nick, I think we were forcing a vote too early before we actually had a chance to come to a place where collectively we were kind of unanimous. I mean, mostly, you know? So I think that our system actually creates polarities. And the Tea Party and all of these things are created because there's winners and losers in our system. And what I see Occupy, one of the powers of Occupy to me, is that it's about making everybody a winner, or as many as possible a winner. That life is a winner, that earth is a winner, that our nation is a winner, that all globe nations are winners. And that's what we really want. And I think that we are missing the mark. We're following the rules, the Robert's Rules of Order, the general democratic process. And it's not the principles that we're opposed to, or Occupy that I see, as opposed to, it's the process itself that causes problems.
Thank you. The first and next one, just there. For the panel, a year from now, what do you want to see happen with OS? What would be a sign of success in your opinion?